CNN's Brianna Keilar gives us a good review and a reminder of Donald Trump's history of stroking violence and how so many in his administration on his side, especially Senator Ted Cruz, is trying to rewrite history. And my final thoughts after the video.
This is how the President of the United States initially described the domestic terrorists who launched a deadly insurrection on U.S. soil and attacked the Capitol in his name.
We love you. You're very special.
His daughter Ivanka called them American patriots as she asked them to stop attacking the Capitol before she deleted that tweet. But of course, this is hardly the first time the president has complimented violence done in his name or by his supporters. In 2015, after the beating of a homeless man by men spouting anti-immigrant rhetoric saying that Donald Trump was right, he pretended not to know about it. He quickly called it a shame, but then he said this.
I will say, the people that are following are very passionate. They love this country. They want this country to be great again.
He later tried to clean that up, calling the incident terrible. And in 2016, after a protester was punched by a Trump supporter at a rally.
I thought it was very, very appropriate. That's what we need a little bit more of.
In 2017, he tried to be funny, saying this to a Long Island audience that included police, giving officers a green light to rough up suspects.
And when you see these thugs being thrown into the back of a paddy wagon, you just see them thrown in, rough. I said, please don't be too nice. Like when you guys put somebody in the car and you're protecting their head, you know, the way you put their hand over. Like, don't hit their head, and they've just killed somebody. Don't hit their head. I said, you can take the hand away, okay?
Also that year, when neo-Nazis showed up in Charlottesville, Virginia, he tried equating them with the counter-protesters who were speaking up against them.
You had a group on one side that was bad, and you had a group on the other side that was also very violent. And nobody wants to say that, but I'll say it right now. You had some very bad people in that group, but you also had people that were very fine people on both sides.
Last year, during the protests over the death of George Floyd, he tweeted, "When the looting starts, the shooting starts." This past summer, he had the National Guard forcibly clear peaceful protesters with tear gas from the street in front of a church near the White House so that he could hold up this Bible here for a photo op. Even Wednesday, he reportedly initially resisted calls for the National Guard to be called up. When his supporters, insurrectionists, were looting, destroying federal property, and invading the Capitol. The president also defended the 17-year-old Kyle Rittenhouse charged with killing two people at a Black Lives Matter protest in Kenosha.
He was trying to get away from them, I guess, it looks like.
Then when the far-right group, the Proud Boys, held a rally to celebrate Rittenhouse, the president was asked during a debate if he'd tell white supremacists to stand down.
Proud Boys, stand back and stand by, but I'll tell you what, somebody's got to do something about Antifa and the left, because this is not a right-wing problem, this is a left-wing.
Trump later denied that that was a dog whistle to the group, even though the Proud Boys interpreted it quite differently. Some have put the phrase on their logo. Some use it as a sort of rallying cry, even selling merchandise with it emblazoned across it. The president has embraced QAnon conspiracy theorists who believe that Democrats and celebrities are running a mass pedophile ring as part of a deep state effort to destroy Trump.
I've heard these are people that love our country and they just don't like seeing it.
And you've heard the president inciting violence at that rally. But look at his fundraising emails in the couple of days before this attack. Defend integrity, last line of defense. Calling on strongest allies to step up to the front lines of this nasty battle. Another one reads, "This isn't about politics. This is about fighting for the future of the nation. Will you fight for your country? In 3 days, we'll crush the radical left." Remember the president's track record when Senator Ted Cruz starts rewriting history. Cruz, one of the biggest Trump enablers and apologists over the years, even after Trump basically called his wife ugly and implied that his father was part of the JFK assassination plot by falsely tying him to Lee Harvey Oswald, the assassin. Cruz, one of the ringleaders of the challenge to Joe Biden's Electoral College win and his rightful position as America's next president. And now, only after this violent and deadly attack in Washington that has left five people dead, including a police officer whose death is now being investigated for murder, one who is at the forefront of this sedition caucus, Ted Cruz, has the gall to say this.
I think yesterday in particular, the president's language and rhetoric crossed a line and it was reckless. I disagree with it. And I have disagreed with the president's language and rhetoric for the last 4 years and have said so many, many times.
Just like a Texas weather vane, seeing which direction the wind is blowing as he changes his story, Cruz says Trump's rhetoric went too far. Trump's rhetoric. What about the guy who fired up a crowd this weekend by comparing the efforts, their efforts, to keep Democrats out of power to the American Revolutionary War?
Each of you look around, the men and women that are gathered here, you are patriots, just like the patriots gathered at Bunker Hill, just like the patriots gathered at Valley Forge, just like the patriots who forged this nation. The men and women gathered here and across the state of Georgia are fighting for the United States of America.
Cruz and all of these other Trump allies abandoning him, like his cabinet secretaries, these are not profiles in courage. These are people who are leaving the arena early to beat the traffic.
I'm gonna make this very, very quick. Who you think you're kidding, Donald Trump? That little hostage tape of a speech yesterday that I picked apart yesterday? We have a history of you stroking violence from 4 years ago all the way to two nights ago, when you inflamed the supporters that showed up in Washington to take back the Capitol. Who are you trying to kid? Your history, your four-year history, will always be remembered as how you incited violence. You encourage violence, you applaud violence, and you actually suggested new violence. I'm terrified of the next few days that you're still in office. Why do you think we're trying to pull you out through the impeachment process, your second impeachment process? Why do you think we're pushing that? Because honestly, we can't trust you that you watch over this country for the next few days to not get us all killed. And as for Ted Cruz, who are you kidding, man? Who exactly are you kidding? You're a traitor. You and the rest of those Republican senators who marched in the Supreme Court hoping to steal the election from Donald Trump, you enabled what happened Wednesday night when Trump supporters bum-rushed the Capitol. And now you're trying to distance yourself from them. Too late. Donald Trump will be always remembered as a man who incited violence, who flamed up his supporters, and got five American citizens killed, one of them a Capitol Police officer. Your legacy, Ted Cruz, we have being an ass kisser to Donald Trump, being a pansy to Donald Trump, because you, any man who talks about my family that way, be it my wife or my father, this fist goes against their jaw. I'm just saying. And you, but for you, Cruz, your lips went on his ass. And it was pathetic. Your legacy is going to be one of treason. Now, I don't have to tell you this, but in a few days, in a couple of weeks, Donald Trump is going to be out of office. And we're going to be celebrating that day. But we also need to keep watch, because One of the victims, I can't believe I'm even calling her a victim. One of the victims of the shootings that happened in the Capitol this week, this Wednesday, an avid Trump supporter, said something along the lines of, "We're just getting started. We won." That's their thinking. So if you think that bum rushing the Capitol was the first part, they are just getting started. Excuse me. Here are the facts. Donald Trump is going to be gone. We're going to be stuck with Ted Cruz for a little bit while longer. But I am calling upon the Senate right now to get him, Ted Cruz, and all the other senators, all the other congressmen who joined in this ridiculousness, who encouraged what happened on Wednesday night, out of the Congress and out of Senate. I'm also calling for both to impeach and remove Donald Trump from the White House now. Not in 10 days from now when Joe Biden is inaugurated, now. We can't take any more time with this because the Trump supporters are planning something else. You know it, I know it. I don't want to sound like an alarmist, but we know that this was just the beginning for them. Get Trump out immediately. Get Cruz out immediately. Get the rest of the Republican senators who supported this treason immediately out. Now, you may not see me on Monday. My team, the Ohio State Buckeyes, is playing the Alabama Crimson Tide for the national championship. I'm so confident that they'll win, but I'm guarded. Now, for my Ohio State football fans out there who are on this page listening to this video, whatever happens, happens. They already made themselves legends this year by beating Clemson in the Sugar Bowl. They're already legends. Let's just sit back and enjoy the game, cheer them on. Hopefully by midnight Tuesday, we'll be celebrating as national champions. Go Bucks. CTP, know the truth. God bless. Peace to the left. Justice to the right.